In life, sometimes we are faced with different kind of battles, and the world is full of battles. How can we handle such thing in this end time? Praise God. Let us pray. Our precious Daddy, Lord, we just thank you for such a time as this. I bless your holy name because I know you are God. Faithful Father, I pray that you will verify your word in the life of the people. You will give them the understanding of your word today, and let your word bless them. Let this word today empower them to stand strong in the time of temptation, so that at the end of it all, they'll give you all the glory. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. In this half of the year, there is a prophetic word that God wants us to take in today. I tell you, when you understand this word, your life will never remain the same. You will always be on the winning side. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, praise God. And in the book of 2 Chronicles chapter 20, I read verse 17. He shall not need to fight in this battle. Set yourselves, stand ye still, and see the salvation of the Lord with you. O Judah and Jerusalem, fear not, nor be dismayed. Tomorrow go out against them, for the Lord will be with you. Praise God. In verse 18, and Jehoshaphat bowed his head with his face to the ground, and all Judah and the inhabitants of Jerusalem fell before the Lord, worshiped the Lord. In verse 21 of it, he said, and when he had consulted with the people, he appointed singers unto the Lord, and that should praise the beauty of holiness. As they went out before the army, and to say, praise the Lord, for his mercies endureth forever. In verse 22, and when they begin to sing and to praise, the Lord set ambushments against the children of Ammon, Moab, and Masira, which were come against Judah, and they were smitten. Praise God. Early this morning, as I was praying, I was having my morning devotion, the Lord said, I should go and minister this word to everyone that is facing battle. As our faces are different, so our needs are. As we all are growing in the Lord, the moment you are set on fire for the Lord, the moment you want to obey God, the moment you want to start serving God in spirit and the truth, the more you dedicate yourself to Christ, the more the battle begin to increase. Why? Because the devil does not want anyone to obey God. He doesn't want anyone to be connected and to build their personal relationship with God. He wants to bring all sort of distraction. It might be distraction of, or losing of loved ones, or losing a job or a career or marriage battle. There are different kind of battles, spiritual battle, home problem. Praise God. There are lots of battles in life. All you have to do is this fourth thing that the Lord released to me this morning. Praise God. Number one, seek the face of God in fasting. When you notice some certain things are happening in your life that you don't understand, and it is ranging, it could be that it's somebody that is causing you the pain. Don't look at that person, because we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers, rulers of darkness in high places. All you need to do is to seek the face of God in prayer. Like the time of Jehoshaphat, he has to go to the Lord. Praise God. He has to go to the Lord. You seek the face of God. Number two, pray in thanksgiving. When you are praying, begin to thank God that I know, God, you have fought this battle for me. I am victorious in every side. I know weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. I know I am not alone in this battle, because I know you are already in the battle. Father, Lord, I thank you because I know you are giving me victory in every side, because I believe in you, because I trust in you, because I hope in you, because I know you said you will fight for me, and I will hold my peace according to your word. In Exodus 14:14, Father Lord, I thank you because your word does not return to you void until it comes to an accomplishment. Father Lord, I thank you because the thought that you have towards me and my family and this situation is victory, victory in every side. Father Lord, when you begin to give God thanks in that battle, you see that the Lord will shift the battle to the enemy's camp. Praise God. Number three, know that God is the battle fighter. Know that God is the battle fighter. Understand this very well. They are not wrestling against you. They are not, you are not the one. Anyone that is fighting a child of God. Listen, as far as you are a child of God, you are born again, you are Holy Ghost filled, and the enemy is fighting you. Know that you are not the one they are fighting. They are fighting the God that you are serving. So you don't need to fight in the battle. All you need to do is just over to you, Lord. Over to you, Lord. Fight for me. And what do? You hold your peace. You don't need to fight in the battle. You don't need to start throwing words. You don't need to start wrestling against flesh and blood. Be calm and be quiet in the presence of God. And you leave it at the feet of the Master. Praise God. Number four, render powerful praise to God. Render powerful praise. Begin to render powerful praise to God. Begin to worship the name of the Lord. Begin to render powerful praises to God. When you wake up in the morning, raise your hands to heaven and begin to worship God. Begin to praise God. Begin to dance. Begin to rejoice. Let the enemy know that they are a loser. You are a winner. That you are victorious in every side. Oh, open your mouth and begin to praise God right now. Open your mouth and begin to worship God. Wherever you are now, begin to praise God. Because in this half of the year, God wants to do a new thing in your life. In this half of the year, God wants to do a new thing in your life. That the ear that we hear it, that ear will tingle. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, you are coming out stronger and better. The victory belongs to God. The victory has been given to you more than 2,000 years ago. I don't know who I'm speaking to right now, but I know somebody is listening to this word today. In the name of Jesus, I declare victory into your life, into your home, into your situation. In the name of Jesus, you are coming out better and stronger. In the name of Jesus, the gates of hell will not prevail against you and your family. In the name of Jesus, you are victorious. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I wish you the best in the next 6 months. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, your battle is over. The battle is over because the battle belongs to the Lord. Please, if you have not received Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, and you have heard the word of God, the sound of God's word through me, I want you to declare this after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I recognize I'm a sinner. Forgive me my sin. Today, I repent from all my sin. Forgive me, O God. And today, I declare you as my Lord and personal Savior. Be my master. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. You are blessed and highly favored. Look for a Bible-believing church where you'll be taught undiluted word that will build up your faith for the return of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Is your sister, Prophetess Mrs. Roslyn Wifo. Remember, Jesus Christ is coming back very soon. Amen. God bless you.